Hi, and welcome to 3dmotive.com. My name is Stephen G. Wells, and I'm a senior 3D artist. In this quick tips and tricks tutorials, we're going to take a look at Maya's interface, viewports, and what we can do with panels and things like that. If you've never used Maya, this is a very, very quick way to get yourself introduced into it. For instance, let's go ahead and look to rotate this view. This is our perspective view. To rotate around an object or around a view, it's just the left click, Alt. Okay, that will allow me to rotate it around. Middle mouse Alt allows me to pan, as you can see. And right click mouse allows me to zoom in and zoom out. Okay. The nice thing with Maya is when you're working with models is you can actually zoom inside the model. We can't specifically do that with Max, at least not and have it show up the same way. This is the perspective view, and if you're not sure, you can always see right here. It says PERSP, which is short for perspective. Right now, I'm just looking at the perspective panel. When Maya usually opens up, you'll get a view something like this. And to get that view, you just hit spacebar. Spacebar will allow you to get to different views. Now, I'm not even clicking in any of these other views. I'm just holding my mouse over this view. If that's the view you want, just hold your mouse over it, and that's the view you get by using spacebar. Spacebar is the viewport toggle. So you can change this as you need to. Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and check the rotate. With this here, this is a divider. This is some of the controls that you can have, some different panels and a little bit of the UI, etc. You can always scale this over. Like if you want more real estate for the panels, you can scale it back to this about this far. You can actually then click on it, just click on the one that's already active, and it'll actually hide the whole panel, so you get more real estate for your viewport. Now obviously this is a bit of a squished, condensed version of Maya. I have to be able to squeeze it in order to record it so you guys can see it. It'd obviously be a bigger screen on yours, so you'd actually have more real estate anyway, but that's how you do it. In order to get the side panels back, you just have to click on them. It's pretty easy. All right, so you have different control functions up here. These are different panels. For instance, you have the general panel. There's a bunch of different things for here, learning about movies, if you have help, things like that. All you have to do is hold your mouse over it as you go over each one of them, and it'll give you a nice little dialog box underneath it as to what it does. With curves, you do the same thing. You have a NURB circle, square. You have the curve tool, the pencil curve tool, and you can go through there. With surfaces, these are the different NURBs you can get. You have the sphere, square, cylinder, etc., and you can just move on through there. With polygons, it's just what it says. It's polygons. It's polygon sphere, cube, cylinder, triangle, plane, torus, etc. All right. There's a bunch of different panels here for other things like animations, etc. I'm not an animator. I wouldn't tend to use any of this stuff. I don't actually have any idea what any of this stuff is because I don't use it. I'm not an animator, so I wouldn't know that. But there will be times as a modeler you might end up using some of the render stuff or some of the paint effects, things like that. I generally use just the polygons tab. Or the nice thing about Maya is if you use a particular creation, you know, you use a particular keys a lot, you can actually create your own custom shelf. These are called shelves. You can also just call them, you know, tabs, palettes. But in Maya, they're called shelves. And in this case, like I have this one that's SGW. So I have my own little shortcuts for modeling, things like that. Like this is vertices, edges, faces, element. I can create soft edges, hard edges. You know, it's any one of these things you can easily create by simply doing adding a specific control. I'll just show you really quickly. If you want to create your own little custom shelves, it's this little arrow right here. Okay, you can click on it. It's shelf editor, as you can see. This is where you can edit some of the stuff in the shelf. Create a new shelf, delete a shelf. If you have shelves loaded, you can load the shelves. Or once you have particular shelves, you can always do the save shelves. Let's just go ahead and do a new one just for this. We'll just call this demo, just so we've got something there. Okay. Let's go ahead and get into our polygons. We're going to just create a quick, I'm just going to left click and drag so I have a sphere. Okay, so there we go. In this case, let's go ahead and make sure, by the way, with some of the different things, you need to make sure that you're in certain elements. This little tab, these are the different shelves or palettes, but this is the different arenas you're going to be in. Like you could be in animation, and this will, all these will kind of change based on what you need for animation. You know, polygon, you notice how that changed up here. Changed the different things for polygons. Surfaces, you notice how it changes all this. Each one of these have their own specific effects that you're going to want to use, or menus that you can turn around and scroll through and use things for. So since we're going to work with polygons, let's make sure we click on polygons so we're there. That way, if we go from editing any of these meshes, etc., we can actually, you know, go right into the editing of the stuff through this as we need to. Okay. For instance, let's just go ahead and grab a face, and I'm going to go to edit mesh, and I'm going to go extrude. Okay, let's just assume that's what we wanted to do. I'm just going to pull that out. Oop, we have our snaps on too. Let's turn that off. There we go. So there we have our extrude, okay? So what we can do is for our demo, we can get to our extrude tool, hold down shift control, and then left click on this. And you see it just added that to our demo shelf. You see that? This is our extrude button. So it just added that to our extrude. Okay. We could do it for anything else. We could do cut faces tool, control shift, and just left click on it. There you go. Poke face, control shift, left click. There it is. And these become your instant little shortcuts for your own little shelf in Maya. It's very easy. It comes in very handy as you're working it. And let's say, again, you don't want it. You're done with it. Make sure you've got the shelf selected, the little tab selected. Click on that arrow and go delete shelf. Are you sure you want to delete it? Yes, we are. There you go. Pretty simple, pretty quick, pretty easy. I'll go ahead and just delete that for now. The beauty about this, Maya, is that you don't have to just have actions create shortcuts. In this case, I actually have my outliner, Maya's outliner, as a shortcut. I have my UV texture editor as a shortcut. And I have my hypershade, it's Maya's material editor, as a shortcut. It's off on my other screen, but I'll drag it back over so you guys can see it. Anything you want, you can turn around and create. So if you go to Windows, let's see, here's the outliner. If I do the control shift and I click on it, I create it. In fact, let's do it again. Let's do another fun one. We're just going to create a new shelf. Again, we'll call this demo. So if you want to create or add your outliner to it, etc., sometimes it's usually good to have it up. Sometimes it's easier to close it. Go to Window, control shift, and click on the outliner. There's your outliner, okay? Find your, whatever you do, rendering editors, general editors, things like that, paint effects, UV texture. Well, here's the UV texture editor. Let's just control shift and click on that. So there you go. Again, it's not just functions. It's not just what you're doing to objects. It's everything you want to be able to use at your fingertips. That's really fantastic about Maya. One of the things I really enjoy most, which is again why I created my own little personal custom shelf, because that way I can get to my things very quickly, very easily, with a button click. And you know, it's one of those that I think is invaluable, and certainly a step up on a couple other 3D programs out there. Maya has a lot of usage for something like that, so I've got to admit I really do enjoy it. Anyway, so that was just basically a very quick introduction to the basic viewport and how to add in your own custom shelves and things like that. It's just a very quick introduction, but it's enough to get your feet wet and allow you to explore with. My name is Stephen G. Wells, and this has been 3dmotive.com, and thanks for watching.